I'll start and we talk a little bit about knee aspirations. So the first thing, like this is a little overview of what we talk about. We just talk briefly about the indications. Then we have like some sentences about how you should get prepared to do it, what equipment you should use. The anatomy is pretty basic. We don't have to talk a lot about the anatomy of your knee, probably. The procedure itself, I'm going to show one in the lab later on, so you know how it's done, and then you just do it yourself. It's probably the easiest way. There will be some take-home message, probably, but it's not a big one. Okay, so there are many indications for knee aspiration. The main thing is probably the problem of bacterial septic arthritis. You can have it in basically every joint. The knee is quite common. Tomorrow we're going to talk about shoulder aspiration. There's the same problem. So the main reason why you want to do anything in a joint? Lee? Sorry. Okay, the main reason why you do anything to a joint is you want to get some probe out of there because you want to have a diagnostic. This is one of the diagnostic criteria to prove there's a bacterial arthritis. So this is the definition of a bacterial arthritis, and I marked iatrogenally red because this is the main problem with this whole puncturing of joints. If you don't do it the right way and you're not doing it in a very, like if you're not careful enough, you can bring bacteria into the joint, and that's like the worst case scenario for you guys. Okay, so it's not like very down below on this slide, it says like 11% mortality for septic arthritis in general. So it's quite serious, okay? So you really have to take care and get to do it in a nice and clean way. These are the Newman criteria. It's just that you heard about it. One of the if one of those points is a positive, it's a go, then you have a high likelihood of having a septic arthritis. So the first and the best criteria is probably the proof of any bacteria you get out of the joint. This is the main reason why you do the puncture. Some other orthopedic guys, they put stuff into the joint. You can surely do this, but the reason why we do puncture a joint in our clinic is to prove there is no bacteria in there. And we try not to bring any in while we're doing it. So these are some of the indications why you should do it. You want to get synovial fluid out of the joint to do any kind of an investigation with that. You want to rule out any infections. Blood is it's a strange indication. That means when you got, for example, you tear your ACL and you got a big fat knee joint, it's very painful. And sometimes it helps if you puncture it and get the blood out of the joint, then it's not much swelling going on. It's less painful for you guys. If it would be my joint, I would not do that because I would be too scared after I got an ACL torn. I would rather take the pain because it's just a pain thing. It doesn't bring any benefits. Lee? I didn't touch anything. It's just a benefit for your pain, but it doesn't bring you any benefits regarding the outcome of the ACL torn, and you still have the risk of getting bacteria back into the joint. So it's rather okay. And the next part is maybe injection of steroids. You can do that. Orthopedic guys do that. So that really makes sense. Here's some of the equipment you need to do it. It's pretty basic. So your gauze, gloves, anesthetic, local anesthetic. The specimen tubes, it depends on which hospital you're working at. We have like special tubes to get the bacterial, like for our lab. Syringes is a good idea. The bandage dressing is fine. And for sure, the most important part probably is antiseptic solution, and you should really take care. We talk about later in the lab how you should do it, but you really should take care that you make it nice and clean. And the most important part, I can show you later, you need a knife that's missing. Actually, you need a scalpel, because you never puncture right through the skin. Because if you do that and the needle has a hole on top of it and you just punch through the skin, you like cut off a piece of skin from the outer surface and bring it directly into the joint. And you have lots of bacteria living on your skin, so this is the worst case. So you should always make a little incision and like spread it and go with the needle through that incision, but not directly through the skin. That's a common mistake and it can result in bad trouble. The anatomy of the knee joint is pretty easy. We don't have to talk much. But does anybody have any questions about the relevant anatomy of the knee joint for this puncture? So you got to make sure if you puncture it, I'll show you later, that you don't hit the meniscus and you don't end up in any ligament, for example, the ACL. Because when you do the puncture, this is where you want to. There are different options. I would recommend this one. This is the lateral. There's this spot. The green spot is called the soft spot. You can feel it on your own knee. It's pretty easy to palpate. And this is where you want to go. And when you want to go in there, image is not from our clinic, so you should make a little incision there before you get in with the needle to avoid bringing skin into the joint. And you aim, where do you aim at? Anybody has an idea? So you know the intercondylar notch where the ACL and the PCL like sit, you want to aim there. It's the same when you do an arthroscopy, when you get in the trocar, you always aim there. You do it, like this is another good trick to relax the quadriceps tendon. When you just let your knee hang down from the shelf, there's always some kind of tension maybe, and this when the quadriceps contract, it like pushes up the patellar tendon, like, and then you have, it's more narrow in there. So you can put a towel like this underneath your calves, your upper thigh, and then it's easier for you to puncture it. While you do it, there are certain structures I already told you, actually, like any kind of cartilage damage would be bad. That's pretty hard to achieve, actually. But meniscus is a problem, and the ACL is quite often punctured. So if you puncture, you just aspirate a little bit and make sure there is some fluid coming out. Then you're right, OK? That's it. You'd want to do it because you want to get some kind of fluid out of there for your diagnostic purposes. What can happen if it's not like a big, fat, swollen joint, but rather a little tiny joint, and you get in and you suck on the syringe, but you don't get much fluid out of there, right? And you know, okay, there is something, but not enough. Then you can use this grip that's shown on the right. You basically use the super patellar recessors, and you just squeeze it out. So there's fluid in there somewhere, and you just squeeze that out to make more fluid coming out for your syringe. That works in most of the cases. That's on the right side of the picture. Any comments on this picture? Is he doing a good job? What do you think? Could you do it better? Yeah, there's probably no incision, right? Yeah, perfect. So when we do it, like he's wearing gloves, right? But the glove doesn't cover his forearm, and we use complete sterile, like in OR setting, we have a complete coat because if like a little hair, that you should be really careful about it. So we do it in a complete sterile environment. We put on a coat and gloves, like a little hoodie, and we cover our mouth to make sure there's no infection going into the knee. Especially when you just do it for a diagnostic purpose, it would be the worst for the patient. Okay, so this should show you the problem with the forearm. Are there any questions regarding this knee aspiration thing? Yeah, please.
Is it specific why it's just done for the knee, or could it be done for like, the elbow or the ankle?
The general rule applies everywhere, so it doesn't matter if you puncture the hip, the elbow, the shoulder. The puncturing, like the technique, is completely different because you need different landmarks. The knee is probably the easiest. the easiest joint to get a needle in because it's straightforward. You feel the soft spot and you just aim for the intracranial, you get it pretty sure. Tomorrow we do the shoulder. That's not hard as well, but it needs a bit more practice maybe to get rid of because there's more bone around it. Really hard to puncture is, for example, the hip joint. I still have trouble because you need, like, the hip is more bony containment compared to a shoulder, right? So it's way harder to puncture a hip. But this one will go easy, you will get it. Any more questions regarding the puncture of a knee? Okay, so I think for my part that's it. So you don't do it like this. We practice it in the lab as soon as possible, and then everybody should try to get at least one try to get in there. It's not bad. We can puncture an elbow or anything that we have elbows as well. It's way more complicated, not way more, but it's a bit more complicated. Okay. So the take home is I would recommend the lateral approach for almost everything, and like in your situation, it's pretty easy. There are like tons of indications. The most important one is probably to rule out any bacterial detritus. You should do it as sterile as possible. And ultrasound, I put it in like a little box because for a knee I wouldn't use an ultrasound. For the hip I would. For the shoulder you could. You don't need necessarily to. But for like a really small joint, like if you want to puncture the sternoclavicular joint or the AC joint, then you need actually ultrasound to make sure you're in the joint because it's very small.